you never leave a fraction in a fraction half. So that's what you're going to be left with. There are two methods that you can use. Method one is using just what we did in the previous lesson and then back to section 5.5 when we were multiplying and dividing rational expressions. We're actually combining two different lessons using method one. You simplify the numerator like a sum problem. You simplify the denominator like a sum problem and both of the written on the common denominator. And then when we divide the fraction, it changes to multiplication by the interval. So we're using what we learned in section 5.6, simplify the common bottom, getting a common denominator for both parts, and then using section 5.5, changing from division to multiplication by the interval. That method is a good method if you want to reinforce what you're doing in section 5.6. It requires sometimes a little bit more work than method 2. Method 2, instead of simplifying the two fractions in the top one, like they're their own problem and then combining them to simplify them, you eliminate the fractions in the very first step. They actually get the fractions. What you do is you look at the entire problem, you find the common denominator of the top and bottom together, you multiply the top and bottom by the common denominator, which is like the sum of one. And in your next step, you have a simplified fractional expression. So you guys will have to decide which way you're going to do it. If you want to continue practicing what you did in section 5.6, you would want to do the number one. Even though it's a little bit more work, it's good practice. If you were good with section 5.6 and you want to try something different that's a little bit less work, then you want to try that. Okay. I'm going to start doing this problem with method one. Method one, and if I was doing method one, I wouldn't write the whole problem down at one time, I would just write the top. You want to get a common denominator up here, and that would be 3. That means this one would be multiplied by 3 over 3. So you would have 3 minus 1, and that means you have 2 over 3. Once you finish that one, you'll be on the bottom. The common denominator down here would be 6. So this one's fine. This one is multiplied by 3 over 3. So we see 3 minus 1, 2 over 6. Can you reduce that? So go ahead and make that 1/3. So remember, this divided by this, you can say that this times the reciprocal of this cancels. So it's sort of a big problem when you get it all together, but if you do the two parts separately and then put them together, it's really not all that bad. Now, if you use method two, you have to look at the whole problem and find the common denominator of the whole problem, which in this case would be 6. So what you want to do is multiply the numerator and denominator by 6. It looks sort of funny the way I have it written because these are fractions. I'm just going to make that 6 over 1 and 6 over 1. When you multiply the numerator by 6, you want to see if you can do any cancel. Here we cancel, you get 6. Here you can cancel and you would get 2. Okay? Here, you can cancel and this would be a 3. Okay? Not going to cancel because it's still 6 when I go here. That's why I don't think you like the chicken. Here you cancel and you get 1. And all you have to do is subtract. Subtract. And reduce. Okay? So if you compare method 2 and method 1, it's a little more than you do method 1. Okay. Next problem. And then we'll do method 1. And on this one, the numerator is x plus 1. Its denominator is 1. It's simplified already. Okay? Down here, your common denominator would be x. So this means multiplied by x over x. So this would be x plus 1. 1 less than 1. Again, just looking at the numerator, the common denominator is x squared, y squared. This one's missing the y squared. This one's missing the x squared. We get y squared minus x squared. That does factor, but I'll wait to do that. Common denominator down here is also x squared, y squared. This one's missing y squared. This one's missing an xy. So I get y squared plus 2xy plus x. Once again, you want to flip this up and change the multiplication. Common denominator the X sample, we get negative 2, now the 2 sample, and then the N again. The method 2 actually works a lot if you get started with any of the factors that you can do. So you are doing 2 to 20 even. You'll notice that your first couple of problems are strictly numeric, arithmetic problems. So I would say if you're not sure which method you want to use, try method 1 on number 2, try method 2 on number 4, and then stick with one the rest of the way through. Almost every homework problem is equally easy in method 2, except